Okay, so we've got this very exciting screen that we're running from the GUI fun method, creating instance of our home class that says enter your name, and then has our text box button, doesn't do anything. What we want to do now is add an action to that button. But the way that we do that is a little bit different. We add, so this is the this brace right here represents the end of the class, right? And this brace represents the end of the main method. What we're going to do is to create a class inside a class. We're going to get really crazy here. And this class doesn't need to be public. It can be private because it's only applicable to this class that we're in. And we're going to call it the my button listener. Okay, that's the name of the class. And this class, in order to be able to do what it's going to do in terms of receiving the information about the action that occurred, that's from the event that's going to lead to the action we perform, it's going to do something called implements the action listener class. Now we've seen this kind of verbiage before. Don't you just love that word, verbiage? That's great. We've seen it when we've extended a class, and this is similar to extending a class. The way it does it is it varies or is different, but the idea is the same. We're going to get the information from the action listener class, so all the methods and properties and everything from the action listener class that will be input into our class that we're creating called my button listener. Anyway, so we've got the extends and the implements, and the difference is kind of beyond the scope of what we're doing here. But in this particular instance, we would use the implements to implement the action listener class. Now we're going to get an error when we do this, saying it cannot find the symbol because action listener is not in the libraries that we've imported to this point. It's actually inside the Java dot AWT dot event dot asterisk. This will import all the classes located in the AWT section, but it doesn't import the subclasses, so we need to go into the event and import all those classes that go along with that. And now it'll recognize that action listener. But it gives us another message because in order for the action listener to work, we have to have a method called action performed. And so that's what we're going to put in now. So we'll create a public void action performed. Now, this is not one we're giving our own name to. This we were giving our own name to. This one is a method that's part of the action listener class that needs to be overrided, which is why we're getting this error. It's not abstract and does not override the abstract method action performed in the action listener. So it wants us to go in and override that method and have it do something when the action's performed. And then what it's going to pass us is a action event that's going to have information about what occurred to make this class be triggered and this event to be triggered. And then what goes in here is what we're going to do when this happens. Now, for now, I'll just say this worked. Okay, so all it's going to do is print out this worked if the action is performed. Now, if I run this program right now, then right now, if I click on OK, it's not going to do anything. Well, wait a second, didn't I just program the action? The problem is I built the action, but an action's just an action. It's a response for what we're going to do when the event occurs. How do we know what event occurred or what this is even attached to? So what we do is after this class is built, this class is an action listener that's going to listen or wait for an event to occur. I'm going to go in and attach this action to the button. So after I build the button, I'm going to say I want to go to button OK and add an action listener to that button. And the action that I'm going to add is the action that I just built, my button listener. And so what I'm going to do is say I want to create a new instance of my button listener. Okay, now I could go in and create an object for this. I could come up to the top here and say I want to create an instance of my button listener and call it something and set it equal to a new button listener. And then I could just refer to that something down here in the parentheses, especially if I was going to be doing it for multiple objects. But where I'm only doing it for, in other words, let's say I was doing it for the, when I clicked on a, when I pressed the Enter key or when I clicked on the OK button, it did the same action, which is a lot of times what we want it to do. Well, then we could build the instance of the action listener and then just attach that instance to both objects. In this case, I'm just creating a new instance of my button listener that I want attached to my button OK. So now when I run this, I have to run it from over here. Then when I click OK, notice it printed down here at the bottom, this worked. Because that's the action I told it to perform when I clicked the button. If I click it again, it prints out this worked again, and it keeps printing it out. Every time I click OK, it prints this worked again, over and over and over again. And that's the action that's performed that I've assigned to be performed to when the button OK is clicked. Now, let me just go back up and do what I mentioned earlier. Let me create a private instance of my button listener and just call it, I'll make it really confusing and call it L1. Don't you love when people do stuff like that? L1, how are you supposed to tell which one's the one and which one's the L? Now let's call it listen1, okay? And that's a new my button listener instance, okay? So then down here, I'll just say go in and to the listen1. Well, I can go in and this should work the same for now. Let me test that. And so, Spencer, and click OK, then it says this worked. If I click OK again, this worked. Well, what if I attach that same action to the Enter key? So I'll say, and by the way, go to the text name and add an action. By the way, whatever I said in the last sentence didn't make any sense. Scratch that from the record. So I'm going to text one now and adding the same listener. So now when I compile and run this, then I can press the OK button and say this worked, or I can type out Spencer and press the Enter key. It will also perform the same action because they're both associated with the same action listener. That's why we do it the way we do it in setting up the action, because the action that's received, the default action in this case, a click on the button or pressing the Enter key in the text box, will both trigger the action, and then I can make it perform whatever it's going to perform. Now what I can do rather than printing out to the console is I can make it do other things, right? For example, because I defined the frame up here at the class level, then that means that everything in here can see it, including this action performed. And so I can use those elements when I perform the action. So I could say, for example, let's go to the frame, which is called home screen, I think is what we called it. So we called it? Yeah. So we can go to the home screen and say, when you click on the action, let's set the background color equal to a specific color. So this is another option for the frame method, is what color is it going to be? Actually, I think it's just set background. And we can set it to a specific color. Well, where do we get the colors? There's actually a color library that comes along with the AWT library. And so we can set the color of the forms. That's another action we'll do. And the way that we access that is to say color dot and then a color. So we're going to change it to blue. When the action's performed, we'll set the background equal to blue. Okay, so let's try compiling and running this. So I click on this and nothing happens. I press the enter key, nothing happens. Okay, back to the drawing board, right? Okay, so this, we're going to set the background equal to the color blue. You know, what I need on standby is one of those little, what is it, like a little trombone thing or something? I need that on standby for when I go to the, we get this great setup. Okay, now we're going to set the background to blue. And then we come in here and we run the program and we say, okay, now let's set the program to blue. Ready, go. Nothing. I think part of the problem is that home screen's already been painted. So let me see if I set the visible back to true again, even though it already is true. This will repaint the home screen. Cross our fingers. No. Wah, 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 wah. Okay. Let's see. Okay, I just used the magic pause button, and I forgot that setting the background of a frame is not as easily done as I might have just done it there. So let's just change what we're doing here for a second, and we'll set the text background. That'll be easier. Okay, so if I click the OK button, then I'll change the color of the text background to blue, hopefully. Okay, there we go. The way that the frame works, it's got this container that we need to set up first and then set the background color to the container. It's a little bit just more complicated, so we'll skip that now for now. But that's now, look, the action performed. And if I run this again and then press the enter key in that box, it'll perform the same action because that's the way the action listener has been set up, right? And so this is how the action listener works. We create the class for it. And by the way, this doesn't have to be an inner class. We could create this as a completely separate class and then call that class just like we did up here. This doesn't have to be inside the class. That could just be another class in this same folder. The problem is, how am I going to set the text name background if I can't access the text name? In other words, if I created a separate class, then everything, home screen, label name, text name, button OK, are located inside this class. And so if I want to do anything with them, which I do, then I can't do that from an outside class. And so that's why we look to these inner class action listeners to perform these actions. Okay? All right, well, let's end there, and then we'll move into the next video to actually do something useful with this knowledge that we've gained. Spencer. Wah, 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 wah.